So my first question to you, what I was interested, what got you on this topic? Like when, where did you start researching this, or how did this start?
Well, I when I was a kid, I kind of wanted to be an astronaut. I really liked looking into astronomy. I've always been very interested in science. And I think how people would get blasted when they would say that we never went to the moon. And when I saw Obama make mock Trump in that one breakfast, he's like, you know, you got more important things to think about. Like, did we fake the moon landing? And just to hear that evil cackle, I was like, something's going on with this thing. But yeah, it's kind of like what you were talking about before. Like when Ron Paul said that, like that story you told once about that one congressperson that didn't know we were off the gold standard.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, that's your job. Anyway.
And she was, just to say, she was also on the House Banking Committee. Not even just a congresswoman. Unreal. She was specializing in this.
Operation, what was it? Operation Paperclip was, NASA was founded by SS Nazis. You know, Wernher von Braun was one of the top Nazis. Operation Paperclip, we brought him on to, and people are like, where's your sources, Breitbart? I'm like, CIA.gov, NASA.gov. So anyway, we didn't go to the moon, and it's one of the few times where it's so easy to prove that we didn't. Like normally proving a negative is almost impossible. You saw that with the Kavanaugh hearing where it's like, prove you didn't rape me. It's like, what? But so it started with this guy, Pettit. He's a high level NASA guy. He's an astronaut. He's been to the space station, allegedly, like 3 times. And he said that we would go to the moon. I'd go back to the moon in a nanosecond, but we no longer have that technology. We destroyed that technology, and it's too painful to rebuild that technology. That's, you can watch this video on YouTube. Okay, that's a NASA guy. Okay, that's insanity. So then you go, well, where's the proof we went to the moon? Something called telemetry data. So they show America this live video of them walking on the moon, and it's real grainy and shitty, but they're like, no, we have all of the footage. It's all documented. We keep it in a vault. It's very safe. Okay, they don't have any of it, right? So 1 metric ton of telemetry data, all the tapes, goes missing. And when pressed, NASA said that they reused the tapes because they had budgetary problems in the 70s. So bear in mind, they go to the moon. All the proof, all of it, they erase. Because apparently there was a Friends marathon. They've never not had a giant budget. Like, that's mind blowing. That's like, we still have Lincoln's hat in the Smithsonian, but none of the proof of the moon landing. Okay, you can't do a live broadcast from the moon now. Because that's one thing. Because I try not to talk about things I'm not an expert in. You know, the Van Allen belt can become this whole thing that people make arguments on. And I'm not a Van Allen belt expert. I've seen inconsistencies in arguments, but I do know about mass communication, about TV production. So the amount of energy you need and the amount of stable satellites and just tech that you need to do a live broadcast like 60 miles is pretty mind-blowing. So back in the late 60s, we're talking about a planet spinning 240,000 miles away through a radiation belt. They have no power source. They're on there with this moon lander that literally looks like you just gave some kid a bunch of Adderall and glue. You know, it's just stupid. They do a live footage with only a 4-second delay because the retards didn't realize that, like, with all the things that live video has, that would have been a 15-second delay now. They couldn't have aimed it to Houston. They couldn't have triangulated. They couldn't have done any of that. They didn't have the power. You know, you need 150,000 volts to even do it a few miles. They had like, what, 12? So that's faked. The moon rock that Neil Armstrong gave Holland turned out to be petrified wood. All the moon rocks have brass and a uranium isotope in them. That brass is man-made, and the uranium isotope is the only exists on Earth. And all the moon rocks have traces of that, so they all clearly are from Earth. And no other country ever went back. And even though, and one of my arguments, this is the thing that made me obsessed about it, is I would say, why didn't we ever go back? They're like, because it's a dusty old moon. There's nothing there. It's too expensive. I'm like, people are still climbing to the top of Everest for no reason. Like, why are we not going back? That would be the most valuable place to have a science base. You know, you could study the universe without an atmosphere. It's like celebrities, billionaires. I would sell all my possessions to go to the moon for like 10 minutes just to like run really fast and jump like a black dude. You know, it's like none of it makes any sense. And so what other time? So the thing I asked somebody once in a debate about this, I said, just explain to me. Don't put it on me. I'm going to put it on you. Tell me any other time in human history when these anomalies have happened. Technology went in reverse. What other time did we have a technology in the late 60s that not only do we not have now, we can't even recreate it? That doesn't happen. Technology does not go in reverse. It should be way exponentially cheaper. Yeah. What other time in history does someone do something amazing and then destroys all the evidence of it? What other time in history does someone explore a new place and a bunch of other countries don't immediately also go and put their flags there? So no other country ever had any desire to go to the moon. They're like, oh, America did it. That's it. Okay. None of the moon rocks are from out of the United States. Neil Armstrong, after having a very bizarre interview and a lot of inconsistencies, was never allowed to give an interview again until he was almost dead. Like, none of it makes sense. And it's like, you know, no one's ever jumped more than 16 inches on camera on the moon. And it's 1/6 the gravity, which makes no sense. And someone was like, well, yeah, but they had 100-pound packs. I'm like, it's 1/6 that. You know, so even if you're like a, it's just people don't have critical thinking skills anymore, and they right. want it so bad that they just do that. And that's a linchpin. And people are like, so why do you even care? Because we give NASA $24 billion a year to lie to us and tell us stuff that isn't true. They're one of the main archetypes of the global warming situation that's designed to centralize all energy. And it's like, how does, like, it's almost impossible to prove something didn't happen, but yet you can. Wernher von yeah. Braun said when he was first working on it that we would need a rocket the size of the Empire State Building to get even close to it. You know, like these guys, and it makes total sense why they did it. I'm not even necessarily blaming them. So we're in a Cold War. We're in a space race with Russia. Russia is lying to a degree that we couldn't have known back then. You know, they're like showing us rockets that are actually the size of Coke cans. So we're like, oh, they're almost there. We got to like win the Cold War. And then you got, you know, methed out John F. Kennedy being like, I say we go to the moon. And everyone's like, fuck. You know, the scientists are like, dude, we're not even close. And Kennedy's like, well, jobs and moon. And so he's made a commitment to go to the moon by the end of the 60s. They start taxing the fuck out of Americans. Every American, including babies, had to pay 40 cents tax, you know. And so they had to pull it off. And in 68, 67, we're talking about, you know, Kennedy's been shot, but before then you got Bobby killed, Martin Luther King Jr. killed. The nation doesn't want to be in Vietnam. It's ripping itself apart. Vietnam's being lost on televisions, you know, in people's living rooms. Like yeah. all of the pieces are in play to fake the moon landing. It's like, okay, let's give them something in their living rooms that isn't their children dying in a pointless war. Voila, the moon landing. And lo and behold, you have a guy who just directed 2001 A Space Odyssey. And, you know, and then in The Shining, he has like Apollo sweaters. Eyes Wide Shut came out to the day 30 years after the first Apollo mission. Just like in Wag the Dog, it's like this director, Kubrick, was like dying to tell people that he pulled off the greatest hoax of all time, but he couldn't. And then he mysteriously dies of a heart attack when he wasn't sick. And it's like, why wouldn't people see that? And then, of course, I'm labeled again as a conspiracy theorist and blah, blah. It's like, name me one time when you have a technology and then you just destroy it and you can't recreate it. That's insane.
That certainly seems very strange to me. What really also the idea that no other country went. That just seems really, because for the same reasons that America would want to go, to be like, see, we beat the Russians. We're the fucking best. We're on the map. Right. Now our flag's on the moon. You would think that another country would want to go to send that message. Hey, we're there too. I mean, if you look about something like nuclear weapons, which, you know, do exist, and there's been several tests, and they've even been dropped on human villages by the U.S. military. Those, as soon as that's done, then one other country gets it, a couple other countries get it, more countries get it. The technology just seems to spread. Now we have bombs far more capable that make Hiroshima and Nagasaki bombs look like nothing. Like, you know what I mean? And like, they just get like, they advance and advance and advance. It does seem very odd that there wouldn't have been another country who would have been like, for the exact same reason that America did it, we're going to go, just so now we're kind of on the map as a major player. That does seem strange to me.